of comedy. If you enjoy her tonight, I would encourage you to check her out again every third Tuesday at Full Steam. She hosts Full Town Comedy. She also does a weekly open mic at Sam's. So if you guys are watching us and thinking, hey, I can do that, come show us. Yeah, I dare ya. That's at Sam's bottle shop here, the one close to Irwin. And she's got a whole bunch of other awesome things, but I'll let her tell you about that. Let's bring up Miss Deb, everybody. Woo!
Yeah, thank you. How's it going, Bull City Ciderworks? You guys having fun still? All right. You're not too drunk? You ready for one more comedian?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
I got all dressed up for you tonight. I wore the only dress in my closet that cost me $1. This one. I'm happy to be doing comedy, especially since, like, okay, I kind of messed up at work, okay? For those of you who don't know, and I'm sure that's all of you, I'm a barista, cashier, food runner at a cafe, bakery, restaurant in Durham. And this is how I messed up. We were short-staffed a couple months ago, and me and another employee worked really, really hard to make sure that everything ran smoothly, and we did a really good job. And I felt good until the next day when my manager ruined it by saying, hey, Deb, I heard you really brought your A game yesterday. Good job. Fuck! They know I have A game. Oh, I was hoping they wouldn't figure that out until like my last day when I was like, ha ha, I've been carrying two plates this whole time. What's that, latte art? It's a fucking leave, enjoy. I also had a weird week this week because I had gone to a fight with a friend. She said to me, Deb, every time we hang out, it's just all about you. It's Deb this and Deb that and your stupid problems and your life. And you never ask about me. You're selfish. You're a selfish person. I know, right? Like, that's a rough thing to hear from your therapist. Like, I didn't see that coming at all. Let me tell you, awkward session. At the end, she was like, Deb, please remember, I am your therapist, not your friend anymore, because you fucked that up and we're never coming back. And I do see a therapist because I was diagnosed with anxiety and depression. There's no need to feel so bad for me, guys, jeez. All right, no shocked faces. That's okay, no one else was either. Especially me, because I was a total SJT in high school. Anyone else? SJT? Sad Jewish teen? Just, no? Ah, we got another one. Yeah, okay, so we got two in the audience. Back me up. Sad Jewish teens were the exact same thing as regular sad teens. We just had to cut ourselves in Hebrew. You can laugh at that, it's a comedy show. So if you look at my scars, it's right to left, and that's how you have to see them. If you understood that part, mazel tov.
L'chaim, here we go.
And I'm Jewish, and you know that because I told you. That and the eyebrows, but because if there's one thing you can rely on with Jews, is that we're going to bring it up. We're going to talk about the fact that we're Jewish. Yeah. Have you ever met a Jew that never talked about it? You haven't, have you? Have you ever seen a Jewish comedian that never brought it up? You haven't, have you? I'm answering that for you. And I've wondered for years why we do this. Because honestly, you think we'd know better than to draw, like, undue attention to ourselves? Like, historically, hasn't worked out. I know you're thinking, oh shit, Holocaust joke. No, all of history reference. That's just an all of history joke right there. One of us got crucified for talking. Guys, like, it's a big issue. That was a Jesus reference. I'm reminded I'm Jewish in, like, the weirdest of ways. Like, even the gym I go to, which I admit is the JCC. Durham. The JCC is at 1937 Cornwallis Road. That's the address, which means that my Jewish gym has 1937 on the building, which is a weird way to remind me why I need to stay in shape. Like, that's just, you could, again, it's a comedy show. You can laugh at, you know. That was a Holocaust reference. No, but you know, I've wondered why we talk about ourselves so much, and I have figured it out. I've thought about it long and hard, and this is what I've come up with. It's because what we're actually trying to say is, hey, guess what, I'm white! But interesting. And we're not interesting, we're just white. Just not white enough for the Klan. And that's the distinction between us and all other white people. And the Klan calls us a dirty race, which I think is really unfair. Personally, you might agree. Because we're not dirty, and we're certainly not a race. Do you know what Jews are? Like, our core, what Jews really are? We're a group of people that got together thousands of years ago and decided we all really like salmon and complaining, and that's it. That's all we are. I married an old Jew, just to make sure it settled in. He's right there. He brought me my wedding ring because I forgot to put it on. I say old because there's a little bit of an age gap. Like, I'm 31 years old. He's 41 years old. I'm fucking with you. He's 51 years old. That is 100% true. And people are always used to be like, oh, he's just grabbing the cradle. And I'm like, nuh-uh, I'm raiding the tomb. Come on, credit where credit is due, people. Deborah Ronan, Tomb Raider. Side note, Lara Croft never earned that title, as far as I'm concerned. What has Lara Croft done? Robbed a sarcophagus? I've touched wrinkly old man balls. Tomb Raider. Thank you. A lot of benefits to marrying an older man. Like, people are like, what are you gonna do when he gets even older? I'm like, well, that's gonna happen, that's how time works. But it's actually really nice, because if it doesn't work out, like, I don't need to file for divorce. I can just wait. And just wait, just be patient. He actually, like, I work in a restaurant, but he has, like, a fancy job. He works at Saks. And his fancy job at Saks came with a life insurance policy, which I had nothing to do with, but it is $300,000. So, I have a new fetish. I masturbate while I watch him at the top of stairs. Baby, can you go up a few more steps? I'm almost done. $250,000. $275,000. I don't need to explain masturbation to you. You guys know how it works. You don't. You've all done it before. He was a little immature when we met. Like, he couldn't wear a condom inside me without being like, not touching you, not touching you, not touching you. Sometimes when I masturbated, he'd just grab my hand and be like, why are you fucking yourself? Why are you fucking yourself? I know you're thinking that joke is inappropriate, Deb. Your vagina can't be up here. I'm like, well, I'm tall in my head, so it is up there. So, that's my mature response. But, I mean, I love him so much. He's creative. Like, he used to write fan fiction for some show called To Catch a Predator. I had to take his word on that for years. I couldn't bypass the parental lock he put on my computer. Like, so many of the jokes I originally wrote about our relationship were, like, edgy-ish back when I was in my 20s and he was, like, in his, like, 40s. But now, I'm in my 30s, and he's in his 50s, so it's not risque, we're just two sad adults. But I love him so much, and he puts up with me and all my awkwardness, because I am awkward. I don't know if that's become clear yet. That I'm slurring my words after literally drinking this much cider. The most awkward I've ever been was when I met my father-in-law, actually. I met his dad in his office because he is a chiropractor. And I said, hi, nice to meet you. My dad is also a doctor. He's not a chiropractor, he's an endocrinologist. A little stilted, but that would have been fine had I said that. I did not say that. I said,
verbatim,
hi, it's nice to meet you. Cool, you're a chiropractor. My dad's a doctor too, but he's not a chiropractor, he's like a real doctor. And then I doubled down while trying to fix it. Oh, no, 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 that's not what I meant. What I meant to say is my dad went to medical school. One more time. What I meant to say is my dad prescribes medication, not crystals. And then I just left, because I wasn't going to get any better. But we get along now, and that's the important thing. I also get along with my mom really well, which is even a more important thing, in my opinion. Like, I teach my mom new things every day. Like, you can get postpartum depression 31 years after giving birth. That's one thing I taught her. Luckily, I'm real big now, so she can't shake me very hard, so it's okay. You know what's funny? She doesn't like that joke either. I don't know. He puts me in a lot of awkward situations, this one. Like, here, I'll tell you this story. We were driving from the Triangle to Fayetteville to visit people. I don't want you thinking I'm just like going to Fayetteville for fun. And I had to pee, so he stopped at this place called Cafe Risque. First off, they don't even serve coffee. Like, it's bullshit. Secondly, it's a really seedy strip joint because this strip club has like, it's like a shack in the middle of a gravel circle surrounded by woods. And it's not the nicest place. Like, it's not a great sign when you go into an establishment and instinctively know that you just smelled chlamydia. Like, it's not, having no reference to it whatsoever. You just know what it is. And there was a dancer on the stage. But you guys know it's about to happen. And
I don't want to break
a mic stand, that's not mine. And first of all, her boobs started like here-ish, but they ended like here-ish. So like there was a lot of movement, right? So I'm gonna just do an impression of her real quick, okay? So this is dancer on stage, Cafe Risque in Dunn, North Carolina. Wednesday at 2 p.m. Oh, these are tits. You're never going to earn equal pay in the workplace with moves like that. Like, that's just crazy. So I can't tell you exactly how much toilet paper I put on that seat before I sat down to pee. What I can tell you is that it wasn't enough. which I found out later at the abortion clinic. I took that joke too far. I freely admit that. Okay, now, before I wrap all this up, I want to just ask you guys something. How weird can I get? Because I had some jokes that I crossed out. Just
keep it going.
You what? You okay?
Yeah.
I'm going to do a joke I crossed out. Are you sure about this?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. So this is just like something that's been vexing me for a while. Because like just fucking once, I would like to see an animated Japanese woman with a tentacle rape whistle. And I don't think that's too much to ask. You said this was okay, and I'm blaming you. No, it's not. It's mine. I don't think it's too much to ask, okay? Like, it's been an issue for millennia. Japan is an old culture. Why is the ocean life in Japan so sexually aggressive? Is this a whaling? Like, why? We need to get to the bottom of this, guys. No doesn't just mean no in Japan. No means no! Okay, I counted 8 preach tentacle. That's good. Where's Gloria Steinem just like walking across an anime going, take back the night, kawaii? I don't know. I can tell you this though. Law and Order, Special Victims Unit, hentai edition. I'd watch the shit out of that. Are you kidding me? Who else? I'd watch that. Just me, okay. Just so I could see Detective Olivia Benson like have to describe sucker marks on a victim. Just be like, oh God, this poor girl. He used to beak. And then of course Ice-T comes out, sorry for your loss, because it's Special Victims Unit. And that's why anybody watches SVU. Ice-T's growth as an actor. Like that's season 2. Sorry for your loss. Season 16, sorry for your loss. It was subtle, but you almost forget that he was ever a good rapper. Anyway. Couple more things. I've started shaving. Again. Yeah. My vagina. Like, that's where I was going. My vagina. Like, this. I'm doing this motion. I don't want you to get the idea that I'm doing this motion because, like, it's covering all this. Like, it's not a jungle. I've still got my triangle, is what I'm trying to say. I've still got my Raleigh Durham Chapel Hill. That is all there. Okay. Now and then it goes out to Hillsboro. Okay, sometimes it goes up to High Point, but I swear that's as far as it goes. All right, sometimes it goes out to the Outer Banks in the middle of Point. But that's a certain kind of thing. Fayetteville's in the back. And Dunn is in the middle, for reasons I explained earlier. And if you're wondering, according to you, in this, like, geography lesson, what is it when there's, like, no hair to guide you at all, and it's just pale and white men biting? That's a carry.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's a carry. Yeah. You're grounding because it's true. That's okay. I don't do what they call a landing strip. Are we all clear on what a landing strip is?
Yes.
Okay. It's not the little box that's in Adolf Hitler. For obvious reasons, I don't do that one. Husband gets an erection, it's like a Sig Heil, it's weird. We use spermicide, it's like millions of Jews die. It's weird, it's awkward. No dead Jews in this oven, that's my motto. It's a weird motto, but I already said it into a mic, so I'm gonna stick to it. So I don't do that, and I don't do the landing strip. Now that is when you take all the hair away, except for one strip to guide you to the vagina in case you can't open the legs. And they call it a landing strip, which I find so inappropriate. Like, seriously, guys, we cannot be calling it a landing strip. We should be calling it a Gaza strip, and I need you to stay with me on this.
Oh, God.
Because I forced all my other pubic hairs to relocate. Hold up. To the toilet, which is way shittier. And I bet you didn't think I was going to turn a vagina joke into a political joke. But I did, because I graduated from college. Now, I'm going to end this with an impression of somebody I just hate. Guys, ever had someone in your life that you're just like, oh, I can't get, I just know this fucking person. Let me just do an impression so you know how horrible they are. Well, for me, that person's Ivanka Trump. And I hate her because she's actually like slightly smarter than her dad, at least I think, which means that she chose that voice. That voice, you guys know that voice. The voice where it sounds like she's just constantly recording like some bad like sex song for the background of amateur porn. Yeah, it's awful. And she's all over the place with this. Like, she was at the Winter Olympics, and it pissed me off. Just, she was watching curling, and I hated it so much. It was, I like how they throw the stones down the pebbled ice. I know it's, you think it's not cool for me to be here, but I know that you want to ask me about my father, but it's inappropriate. How dare you ask me about those other women accusing my father? You might call him the worst president. You might call him insane, inane, and a complete fucking idiot. You might call him the worst person. Guys, thank you so much. I've got shows coming up this week. Ask me afterwards. And thank you so much for coming out to the show.